everyone, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Lalita and today in this video I am going to discuss about 4G smartphone trainer and its order code is 2223UN0175.38. This trainer board is an ideal training equipment to teach the operation of 2G dual SIM mobile phone. Now I am going to giving you an overview of 4G smartphone trainer kit. So in this trainer kit we have different blocks for the benefit of users. The first block is dual SIM block where we can connect the SIM, and then we have the display block. After that we have the lithium ion battery block where we will connect the battery, and then we have the volume control block, and then we have the mic block, hand free mic block, earphone block, vibrator motor block, USB block, speaker block and power supply block. Now we will start the experiment one by one. Now we will start the experiment first to study the 4G smartphone trainers. In this first experiment we will learn about the 4G smartphone trainers, like the theory of smartphone, history, technology, shapes, working, mobile communication and mobile technology, evolution of mobile communication technologies, mobile internet communication technologies, technical understanding, background of 4G, frequency for 4G LTE network, etc. So you can go through the lab manuals and can understand whole information of this apparatus. In this experiment we only learn about the theoretical knowledge of this apparatus. So we will continue through the next experiment. Now I am going to start second number experiment to study of block diagram of the trainer. So first of all we have the dual SIM block. Trainer has on board two dual SIM slots, namely as SIM1 and SIM2, and here we have switch FSSW1 and FSSW2 are provided on this block to create the fault and observe the effect on the system. After that we have the lithium ion battery block, and we can check the battery voltage at positive switch FSSW3 is provided on this block to create the fault and observe the effect on the system. And after that we have the display block. The trainer has no board super AMOLED capacitive touch screen display. This will be used as display of the mobile phone. And in this mobile phone we have keypad block, power key, these are the power key. Then we have the volume plus to increase volume of 4G smartphone trainer, and volume negative key to decrease volume of 4G smartphone trainer. Switch FSSW4 is provided on this block to create the fault and observe the effect on the system. After that we have the mic block, and the trainer has on board mic block to be used as audio input. Fault switch FSSW5 is provided on this block to create the fault and observe the effect on the system. And after that we have the hand free mic block. This is the hand free mic block, and this block is used to connect to the external audio devices such as headphones, speaker to listen the audio, and mic to give audio signals. Fault switches FSSW6 is provided on this block to create the fault and observe the effect on this system. And after that we have the earphone block, and this block is used to connect to the external audio device such as headphones, earphones and speaker to listen the audio signals. And after that we have FSSW7 is provided on this block to create the fault and observe the effect on the system. And then we have the vibrator block, vibrator motor block, and this vibrator block is used when its function is used in the profile. It vibrates for incoming call when it is on in the selected profile. Fault switch fs as w8 is provided on this block to create the fault and observe the effect on the system. After that, we have the USB block, and this USB block is used to connect the mobile phone trainers with the computer or laptop for data transfer, mass storage, or charging other electronic device. And we have fault switch fs as w9 to provide on this block to create the fault and observe the effect on the system. And after that, we have the speaker block, and this is the inbuilt speaker of the mobile. Fault switch fs as w10 is provided on this block to create the fault and observe the effect on the system. And at the end, we have the supply power supply block, and this block gives plus 5 volt output of the charger when AC supply is connected and battery is charging. Fault switch fs as w11 is provided on this block to see create the fault and observe the effect on the system. Hence, through this experiment, we have studied the block diagram of 4G smartphone trainer. Now we will start the next experiment. Let's start the experiment third, working of 4G smartphones trainer to understand the working of mobile phone trainers. We will start the procedure step by step. First of all, we will connect the apparatus to the AC supply. After that, we will connect the SIM in the SIM slot. And then we will put the all fault switches FS SW12 FS SW13 at on position. We will check the all switches on position. And after that, we will switch on the apparatus, and we will press and hold power button key till mobile phone get switch on. Phone is switch on. And after open the phone, you can operate the mobile phone trainer as per your need, like turning the device on and off, it takes few seconds to open. So you can see phone has been started. Now we will understand the working of this kit. You can see this is the display of phone, and in this display we have home screen is starting the point for accessing all of device features. It display widths, shortcuts to app and more. To view other panels, we can swipe to left or right or top of the screen. You can see on that screen we have different apps, and here we have the searching for items bar. Here, from here we can search the items. From this button we can back. And in this phone we can make the patterns, pin and passwords. And in this phone we have gallery. We This is the gallery where we can store the photos and videos. So in this phone we have different facilities, same as we have in our mobile phones. Now we will start the next experiment to charging of 4G smartphone to understand the charging of 4G smartphone trainer. So first of all, I will connect this system to the AC supply and we will insert the SIM in SIM slot, and after that we set all fault switches FSW1 to FSSW11 at on position. You can see all the switches are on position. After that we will switch on the trainer. Now the battery will start charging. You can observe the same on display. You can see here the battery has been started to charge. Now we will measure the battery voltage at TP9 of FSSW3 with respect to ground. You can see on the display of multimeter, the value of voltage is approximately 3.89. Hence, we have studied the charging of 4G smartphone trainer. Now, we will start the next experiment. Now, we will start the experiment to voltage and signals at different test points. And with the help of this experiment, we will measure the value of voltage at different test points. So, first of all, I will connect the positive of the multimeter at different test point of the power supply block, which are given in table. According to this table, we will connect all the test point to the multimeter one by one. And we will connect the negative side of the multimeter to the ground. So let's start to connect the multimeter to all test point and check the value of voltage, and we will also measure the signal through the DSO. Currently I am not having the SIM card, so you can check the value of voltage by connecting the voltmeter on TP1 to TP8. So I am going to check the value of voltage from TP9. I will connect the ground here and TP9 through the display of multimeter. You can measure the value of voltage and can note down. I also can check the signals through the DSO by connecting the DSO channel. You can see the variation in the waveform by connecting the channel to TP9 and to ground. Similarly, we can check the value of voltage through TP11 or TP10, TP12. You can see the value of voltage at TP11 is approximately 0.05. And we also can measure the waveform through the DSO. You can see there is very minor difference between waveform on DSO because the value of voltage is very low here. So like that, we can measure the value of voltage through the multimeter to all test points. If I want to check on the volume block the value of voltage, you can see the value of voltage at volume is approximately 1.84, and I also can see the signal you can see the waveform which are showing on the DSO. So like that, one by one we will test all the points and we'll measure the value of voltage, and we can see the value of voltage on display of multimeter, and we also can see the signals on the DSO. Now we will start the next experiment to study of fault switches to demonstrate and understand working type of fault. So we will start one by one. If I block pin 1 at that time, SIM 2 will not get clock pulse, display will show SIM card removed, and if I block pin 2, SIM 2 will not get RST signals, and if I block pin 3, SIM 2 will not get power supply, display will show SIM card removed. If I block pin 4, because of that SIM 2 data will not work. Similarly, SIM 1 block will work. Now we will talk about battery block FSSW1. If I block pin 1, because of that battery connection will get disconnected and mobile phone will get switch off. So let's block this pin 1. You can see my phone has been switched off, and if I open that pin again, my phone will be open. It takes some seconds to restart again. You can see our phone has been started, and if I block pin 2, battery information will get disconnected. Here you can see it showing the battery connection, and if I block this pin 2, the battery connections has been removed from here. I will open it back, and if I block pin 3, battery connection will get disconnected and mobile phone will get switched off, and if I block pin 4, battery temperature information will get disconnected. Now if I block pin 1 of FSSW4, because of that the decreasing volume button will get disconnected, volume will not work. You can see it's not working. If I block pin 1, the volume increasing button will block and it will not work, and if I block pin 2 at that time, the negative volume button will stop to work. You can see. If I block pin 3, because of that left side power key get disconnected, power key will not work. you can see this button is not working, and if I open it back, it will work. You can see. And if I block pin for right side, power key get disconnected, power key will not work. If I block pin 4, this button is will not work. You can see it's not working, and if I open it back, it will work. If I block pin 6, volume plus key button will get disconnected and volume plus will not work. And if I block pin 7, left side power key get disconnected and power key will not work. And if I block pin 8, at that time the right side power key get disconnected and power key will not work. Similarly, we will understand for FSSW5 mic block. If I block pin 1, positive terminal of mic get disconnected, hence will not to be able give audio signals through the mic. And if I disconnected pin 2, at that time ground terminal of mic get disconnected, hence will not be able to give audio signals through the mic. Now we will talk about the hands-free mic block. If I block pin 1, mic get disconnected earphone. And if I block pin 2, SPK get disconnected, hence will not be able to hear audio signals from earphone. Now we will talk about earphone block. If I get disconnected P1, because of that SPKL get disconnected, hence will not be able to hear audio signals from earphone. If I block pin 2 of earphone block, because of that SPKR get disconnected, hence will not be able to hear audio signals from earphone. Now we will talk about FSW8. If I block pin 1, the positive terminal of vibrator will get disconnected, hence it won't vibrate. And if I block pin 2, negative terminal of vibrator will get disconnected, hence it won't vibrate. And if I block USB pin 1, because of that device will get disconnected during media transfer between mobile phone trainer and computer. And if I block pin 2, because of that device will get disconnected during media transfer between mobile phone trainer and computer. Now we will talk about speaker block. For understanding this speaker block, we will start the FM radio. Radio has been started. Now we will understand the fault switches here. If I block the pin 1, positive terminal of speaker will get disconnected, hence it will not respond. You can see the speaker has been stopped. I will open it again. And if I block pin 2, negative terminal of speaker will get disconnected, hence it won't give output. You can see. Now we will talk about power supply block. If I block pin 1, positive plus 5 volt supply of the charger will get disconnected, battery charging will stop. You can see battery charging has been stopped. And if I block pin 2, because of that ground will get disconnected. So that's all the demonstration which is given by me. If you have any query related to this apparatus, you can go through the link which is given in the description. And if you want to know more about this apparatus, you can go through the lab manuals. Thanks for watching this video. If you like it, please like, share and subscribe our channel. Thank you.